Hi, boys and girls. Today we're reading chapter 4 in The Land of Stories, The Wishing Spell. Today's chapter is called The Land of Stories. Alex had been acting strange all week. Connor had noticed right away because she wasn't as talkative and upbeat as she usually was. Instead, she was very quiet and looked like she was about to fall into a deep sleep. When they ate breakfast, she barely acknowledged it when her brother said, "Good morning." During school, she stopped raising her hand as much. After school, she barely said a word to Connor while they walked home. And as soon as they got home, Alex would run up the stairs, lock herself in her bedroom for the rest of the day. "Are you feeling okay?" Connor eventually asked her. "You seem different." "Yes, I'm just tired," Alex said. Connor knew she must be tired because she didn't seem to sleep anymore. Every time he had gotten up in the middle of the night to get a glass of water or to use the bathroom that week, the lights in his sister's bedroom were still on, and he could hear her rustling about inside, working on something. He didn't have to be a genius to know that his sister was dealing with more than just insomnia. He had seen enough health videos at school to know that girls his sister's age were expected to start going through some mood swings and changes. But Alex had become another person entirely. Something very serious was bothering her, and she was keeping it to herself. "Can I borrow some of your pencils?" a wide-eyed and wide-awake Alex asked late one night. It was like a peacock asking to borrow some feathers. He wasn't certain how to handle this request. Surely she wasn't still doing homework at this hour. "Don't you have like hundreds?" Connor asked her. "Yes, but I've lost them all," she said. He shared a few that he had with her, and Alex took them and quickly disappeared into her room again. She didn't even seem to mind that most of them were chewed on and were missing their erasers. The next night, Connor kept waking up to a peculiar humming sound coming from Alex's room. It was quiet, but had a strong vibration that he could feel as much as he could hear. "Alex," Connor said, knocking on his sister's door, "what is that sound? I'm trying to sleep and it's driving me crazy." "It's just a bee. I shoot him out the window," a frantic Alex responded from behind the door. "A bee?" a puzzled Connor asked. "Yes. A very big bee. It's mating season, you know, so they're quite aggressive this time of year," Alex called out. "All right," Connor said and went back to bed. But these happenings were nothing compared to the events during the next day at school. "Can anyone tell me the names of the rivers that ran through ancient Mesopotamia?" Mrs. Peters asked the class during a history lesson. As usual, she had no volunteers. "Anyone?" Mrs. Peters asked. Everyone was looking at Alex and expected her hand to shoot up into the air any second, but Alex was just staring at the floor. She wasn't paying any attention to anything. "The Tigris and the Euphrates," Mrs. Peters informed the class. "Can anyone tell me what this area between these two rivers is believed to be?" She asked the question again in Alex's direction, but it was no use. Alex was lost in her own thoughts. "Miss Bailey, perhaps you know the answer," Mrs. Peters pleaded. "To what?" asked Alex. "The question," Mrs. Peters said. "Oh," Alex said, "no, I don't know." She rested her hand on her head and continued staring at the floor. Mrs. Peters and the rest of the class didn't understand what was happening. Alex always knew the answers. How was a class going to function without her? "The cradle of civilization," Mrs. Peters told the class, answering the question. "Many believe that mankind started there, Miss Bailey." Alex sat up quickly in her seat. The most shocking thing had just happened. Alex Bailey had dozed off in the middle of class. I'm sorry, Mrs. Peters," Alex pleaded. "I don't know what came over me. I haven't been sleeping very well lately." Mrs. Peters was staring at her as if she had just witnessed something crazy. That's all right," the teacher said. "Do you need to see the nurse?" "No, I'm fine. I'm just a little sleepy," Alex said. "I promise I'll never let it happen again." Connor had been watching the whole thing like it was a train wreck. All he could do was shake his head. What had happened to Alex? Where was his real sister? And was she turning into him? The strange humming sound Connor had heard the night before suddenly filled the classroom. Alex sat straight up in her seat, anxious. Her eyes grew larger than they had ever been before. A few of the other students looked around, trying to figure out where the sound was coming from. "Can anyone tell me the technologies Mesopotamia brought into the Bronze Age?" Mrs. Peters asked. Obviously, she was not hearing this humming sound. "Anyone?" she asked again. Alex's hand shot straight up in the air. "Yes, Miss Bailey," Mrs. Peters happily called on her. "May I use the restroom?" Alex said. Mrs. Peters sighed with disappointment. "Yes, you may," she replied. Before she had finished granting Alex permission to leave the classroom, Alex had already jumped up out of her seat, grabbed her school bag, and headed out the door. Connor watched as his sister left. His eyes were bulging with suspicion. Why had she taken her backpack with her to the bathroom? He had to know what was going on. He was going to confront his sister here and now at school, where she had no place to run and no bedroom to lock herself into. "Mrs. Peters," Connor called out. "Yes, Mr. Bailey," Mrs. Peters asked. "Can I see the nurse?" he asked. "What for?" she asked. He hadn't thought this far into his plan. "My elbow hurts," Connor said. Mrs. Peters stared at him blankly. She may have believed him more if he had told her that he was a dinosaur. "Your elbow hurts?" she asked. "Yes, really bad. I banged it on my desk, and now it's just killing me," Connor said, clutching his perfectly fine elbow. Mrs. Peters squinted and rolled her eyes, two of her trademark indications of annoyance in one expression. "Fine," the teacher said, "but I'm going to have to write you a pass." Connor was out the door before she could finish her sentence. Meanwhile, Alex burst into the girls' restroom. She quickly looked underneath all the stalls to make sure that she was alone. She zipped open her school bag, pulled out the Land of Stories, and set it on top of the sink. It was glowing and humming more than ever. Please turn off, Alex said to the book. "I'm at school. I can't get caught with you here." The sound and shine slowly faded, and the Land of Stories returned to being just a normal book. Alex sighed with relief, but panicked once more when someone else suddenly charged into the restroom. It was her brother. "Bees don't have a mating season, Alex," Connor said with a tightened brow and his hand on his hip. "I looked it up. They come from colonies just like ants, even the big ones. They don't have schedules." "Connor, what are you doing in here? You can't be in the girls' bathroom," Alex shouted. "I'm not leaving until you tell me what's going on," Connor demanded. "You've been lying to me all week. I know something's up. I have twin tuition." "Twin tuition?" asked Alex. "I made it up," Connor said. "It means I know something's bothering you, even if you tell me nothing is. At first, I thought you were just having, you know, girl issues." "Oh, Connor, please," Alex interjected. "Then, after all the strange buzzing noises and late nights, I figured Mom must have gotten you a cell phone and didn't want me to know about it. But then I remembered, you have no friends, so who would be calling you?" Alex grunted. Now he was being rude. "But I know you well enough to know that it would take something much worse to make you act this way," Connor said. "You're quiet. You don't know any of Mrs. Peters' answers, and you're falling asleep in class. You're acting like me. So just tell me, what's your problem?" Alex didn't say a word. She just stared at her feet. She was so ashamed at how she had been acting, but she knew no one would believe her if she told them what she had seen. Connor looked around the girls' bathroom. "Gosh, it's so nice in here. The boys' bathroom looks really gross. Wait, why do you have Grandma's book with you?" "I don't know what's going on," Alex burst into loud and awkward tears. One cry when she was exhausted and overly stressed. Connor took a step back for his own protection. He had never seen his sister so hysterical. "At first, I thought I was hallucinating," Alex said. "I thought maybe I was having a reaction to something Grandma made us for dinner. That was the first night it happened. But then it kept happening, so I knew it wasn't a reaction." "Alex, what are you talking about?" Connor asked. "The Land of Stories book," Alex yelled. "It glows. It hums. Every day it gets louder and brighter. I've lost so much sleep trying to figure out how and why it does it. It breaks all the laws of science." Connor said with raised eyebrows. "Alex, I think we should go see the nurse." "You must think I'm insane," Alex told him. "Anyone would come to that conclusion unless they saw it themselves, but I promise I'm telling the truth." "I don't think you're insane," Connor lied, staring at his sister. "It happens once or twice a day," Alex said. "I was afraid Mom would find it, so I brought it to school. The last thing she needs to worry about is a strange book lying around the house." Connor didn't know what to say. He briefly imagined the future trips he and his mother would be taking to see his sister in the local asylum and the wisecracks that he would make about the cool white jacket that she got to wear. Clearly, his sister had lost her mind. But after all they'd been through, he couldn't blame her. He kept thinking about how his dad would have handled the situation. What story would he have used to comfort Alex? Alex, Connor said with understanding eyes. We've been through a lot this last year. It's perfectly normal to feel overwhelmed and... The humming started again. They looked back at the land of stories on the sink. To Alex's relief and Connor's horror, it was glowing. Connor jumped back against the wall as if he were in the presence of an explosion. The land of stories book, Connor yelled. It glows. It hums. I told you, Alex said. Connor's mouth was open so wide it was almost touching his chest. Is it radioactive, he asked. I doubt it, Alex told him. She reached for the book. Don't touch it, Alex, Connor shouted. Relax, Connor, Alex reassured him. I've been dealing with this all week. Using one finger, she flicked the book open and the entire restroom was illuminated. All the illustrations and writing had disappeared and the pages seemed to be made of pure light. Alex leaned closer to the book. Listen, do you hear that? She asked. I can hear birds and leaves. I've never heard sounds come out of it before. Connor edged away from the wall and leaned down with his sister. The sound of birds chirping and trees blowing in the wind echoed off the tile and porcelain in the bathroom. How is this possible? Connor asked. Are you sure it doesn't have batteries or something? My most educated analysis with all means of science and technology in mind is that it's magic, Alex said. There's no other possible explanation. Do you think Grandma knows about this? Connor asked. She had the book for years before she gave it to us. Do you think this has happened to her before? I don't think Grandma would have given it to us if she knew what it was capable of, Alex said. You're right, Connor said. She still cuts my meat up whenever she comes for dinner because she doesn't trust me with a knife. There's more, Alex said. She reached into her school bag and pulled out a pencil. Carefully, she placed the pencil on the open book and it quickly sank into the glowing pages and disappeared. Where did it go? Connor sputtered into utter astonishment. I don't know, Alex said. I've been dropping things into it all week. Pencils, books, dirty socks, anything else that I could find that I knew I wouldn't miss. I think it may be some kind of portal. A portal to what? Connor asked. Alex didn't have an answer. Of course, there was one location that she had hoped it might lead to. The twins leaned down even closer to their book, the noises almost touching it. They had to squint because it was so bright. Suddenly, a bright red bird flew out of the book. The twins screamed and ran around the room in panic. They bumped into each other, into the walls, and into the sinks as the bird zoomed above them. It was just as panicked as they were. Finally, Connor opened the bathroom door and the bird flew out of the room and down the hall into the world. You didn't say things came out of it, Connor yelled. I didn't know. That's the first time that's happened, Alex yelled back at him. The book slowly dimmed and returned to normal. Connor's head was spinning. He couldn't believe all the things he had just witnessed. No wonder Alex had been having such a tough week. He now felt his own sanity might be slipping too. We have to get rid of this book, Connor exclaimed. After school, we should ride our bikes down to the creek and toss it in so no one ever finds it. We can't get rid of it, Alex said. It's Grandma's book. It's been in our family forever. Birds are flying out of it, Alex. I'm sure she'll understand, he said. What if a lion or a shark comes out of it next? I know it drives you crazy when you don't know about stuff, but this is one matter that you need to let go of. It could be more dangerous than we think. Who knows what could happen next? She knew her brother was right. But there was something about the situation that intrigued her past the point of reason. I think you're overreacting, Alex said. I don't want to get rid of it until I know more about it. She closed the book, put it back in her school bag, and walked out of the restroom. Alex, don't walk away from me. Alex, Connor yelled out after her. The twins returned to class, and all the students were silently reading their history books. Alex, we need to talk, Connor whispered. Mr. and Miss Bailey, please have a seat and read the chapter on Mesopotamia. Mrs. Peters ordered from her desk. Yes, Mrs. Peters, Alex said, and then she turned back to her brother and whispered, we'll talk about it later, Connor. Connor let out a sound similar to something a bear would make. Mr. Bailey, how was the nurse? Mrs. Peters asked. There was no need. My elbow started feeling much better before I got there, Connor said, holding the other elbow than the one he had previously claimed was hurting. Mrs. Peters raised an eyebrow so high it was almost above her. The twins sat at their desk and opened their history books, but neither of them could actually read. Their thoughts were so loud it was impossible to focus on anything. Connor kept looking up at his sister, hoping she'd turn around so that he could make some sort of gesture to get her to understand how serious the situation was. Alex could feel her brother's eyes on the back of her head, so she remained facing forward, set on ignoring him. And then the worst possible thing that could have happened, happened. The Land of Stories began humming in the quiet classroom from inside Alex's bag. She looked back at her brother, finally making eye contact. What were they going to do? Mrs. Peters had been so caught up in her lesson plan that she hadn't heard it earlier. Was it possible for her to miss it again? What is that noise? Mrs. Peters demanded. All the students were looking around the room, wondering the same thing. Alex and Connor were terrified. They felt like their stomachs had fallen out of their bodies. Mrs. Peters got up from her desk and started searching around the room, like a coyote sniffing its prey. She walked up and down the aisle and desks, getting closer and closer to Alex. If anyone knows what that is, they'd better tell me before I find it, the teacher warned. Alex could feel her heartbeat in her throat. There was no telling what could happen if her teacher found the book. She could only imagine what a fuss the school would make about this discovery. Perhaps they'd call the local news stations. Perhaps government officials would take the book away for experimental testing. Perhaps her family would be taken away because they had been in such close contact with it. Mrs. Peters arrived at Alex's desk. Miss Bailey, is there something in your bag? She asked her. All the color in Alex's face drained away. She needed a miracle. Suddenly, a large history book flew from the back of the classroom and hit Mrs. Peters on the head, leaving a large dent in her curly hair. The entire class turned to the back of the room and saw Connor's extended hand. He had just thrown a book at his teacher. Mrs. Peters' face turned bright red. A charging bull wouldn't have seemed harmless compared to the way that she was looking at Connor. Mr. Bailey, what on earth has gotten into you? She screamed. The whole school must have heard her. For a brief moment, Connor saw his entire life flashed before his eyes. He honestly thought that he was about to die. His face was so white, he was almost transparent. I'm sorry, Mrs. Peters, Connor said. There was a bee. I didn't mean to hit you. Steam was practically coming out of the teacher's ears and nostrils. Detention, Mr. Bailey, for the rest of the week, and next week, and the week after, Mrs. Peters said. She returned to her desk and immediately began filling out every detention slip she had in her possession. Thankfully, the room had become so tense that everyone had forgotten about the humming sound, and even more thankful that they hadn't noticed it slowly fade away. Connor's mission was accomplished. He knew he'd done the right thing, not as a student, but as a brother. Soon the bell rang and all the students left their desk and filed out of the classroom except for Connor, who remained seated. Alex walked up to him. Thanks for that, she said. You owe me one, Connor told her. She nodded and then left the classroom to walk home alone. Connor remained seated until Mrs. Peters finished filling out the detention slips. Come here, Mr. Bailey, she said. Connor approached her desk as if it were on fire. Throwing things in my classroom will never be tolerated. Do you understand me, Mr. Bailey? She said, heavily pronouncing each syllable of each word. One more instance like this, and I'll have to expel you. He gulped and nodded. She handed him a large stack of detention slips. Your mother will need to sign all of these, Mrs. Peters told him. He nodded again. I'm really sorry, Connor said. I hope I didn't hurt you. He was so genuine that even Mrs. Peters could sense his regret. She knew that deep down, Connor had always been a good kid, a horrible student, but a good kid nonetheless. It's all right, Mr. Bailey, she said. I believe I may have underestimated the effect your family situation has had on you and your sister. I'm going to contact your mother with a list of different after-school programs I think you and your sister should take part in, as well as a list of self-help books that may be beneficial. Connor nodded in agreement. I think if you had some place to escape to once in a while, it would help you deal with whatever you're going through, she said. Connor continued nodding. If there was ever a time in his life when he needed an escape from reality, it was now, and he was sure his sister would agree. And then, like lightning, it hit him. Oh my goodness, Alex, Connor thought. She's gonna travel into the book herself. That's why she's been holding on to it. That's why she refused to get rid of it. Connor dropped all the detention slips and bolted toward the door. I'm sorry, Mrs. Peters. I can't go to detention today. Something has just come up. "Mr. Bailey, get back here right now," she yelled after him, but it was too late. He was already gone. Connor was running as fast as he could down the street. Alex had gotten so much of a head start. Would he be able to make it home in time to stop her? What if she already had gone by the time that he got there? What if he never saw her again? His feet began to ache. A horrible pain grew in his side, and his heart felt like it was beating out of his chest. But he continued running. He just prayed he wasn't too late. It hadn't been more than 5 minutes since Alex had gotten home when the Land of Stories began acting up again. She ran up the stairs to her bedroom and promptly shut the door behind her. Alex took the Land of Stories out of her school bag and placed it on her bedroom floor. She opened the cover and her room lit up with a golden glow. She smiled at herself. Alex had always hoped something magical would happen to her, and now something finally was. She pulled out a pencil from her school bag and placed it on top of the book and watched it disappear. Alex looked around the room for another disposable thing that she could drop into the book. She was out of pencils, and the books left on the shelves were the ones that she really wanted to keep. She looked down at her school bag. She did have plenty of school bags. She placed her whole bag on top of the book and watched as it, too, slowly sank into the storybook. Where were all of these things going? Was it transporting them to another part of the world? Would she find a pile of her school supplies in India or China? Or did the book send the items someplace else entirely? Was it possible that they were going to another world? Was it a world that Alex secretly hoped for? There was only one way to find out. It was an idea she had managed to suppress all week. What if she went into the book? No, she couldn't possibly do something that silly. What if she never came out? But what if she stuck her hand in the book? What would happen? Would it hurt? Would her whole arm disappear? Alex's curiosity overruled her caution. She sat on her knees and bent over the book very carefully. Alex started with her fingertips. So far, so good. There was no pain. She only felt a warm tingling sensation. Alex reached further. Now she was wrist deep. And still nothing happened that would worry her. She went farther. The book was up to her elbow. If the book hadn't been there, her hand would surely be sticking through the ceiling downstairs. Alex leaned forward even farther, almost shoulder deep into the book. She moved her arm around, seeing if there was anything to grab onto on the other side. Suddenly, her bedroom door burst open and Connor ran inside, sweating and out of breath. "Alex, don't do it!" He completely startled her. Alex lost her balance and fell headfirst in the book. "Alex!" Connor cried out to his sister. He jumped toward the ground, trying to grab her foot before she disappeared entirely, but it was too late. Alex had fallen into the Land of Stories. Tomorrow we'll be reading chapter 5, From the Mouth of a Frog. Hope you have a great rest of the day. Bye-bye.